Good morning, friends. This is Sushma Adipu from PT Tutorials OSIS Group. Let's start today's webinar. The topic of today's webinar is repeated material of PTE academic exam. You can find all these repeated questions in the PTE Tutorials app. Download PTE Tutorials app and start practicing. Yes, if you have any queries, you people can ask in the questions box. After completing this presentation, I'll try to answer the questions. Okay, and let's start with the speaking module. As the very first task, read aloud is very important. I'm telling you, read aloud is very, very important. In order to score 79 plus in reading, repeat, in order to score 79 plus in reading, try to be 100% accurate in this particular question. Because read aloud is an integrated task and it is scored for speaking and reading as well. How to be 100% accurate? You should not miss a word, you should not replace a word, or even you should not add a word. Doing this is considered as an error. Okay, and here comes the most repeated read aloud. As you can see on the screen, the first read aloud is electric car. Let me do it first. First year university students have designed and built a groundbreaking electric car that recharges itself. First, 50 students from the University of Sydney's Faculty of Engineering spent 5 months cobbling together bits of plywood, foam, and fiberglass to build the Mango concept car. They developed the specifications and hand-built the car. It's a pretty radical design. A four-wheel drive with a motor in each wheel. Here there are few words like engineering. This is not engineering, that will be pronounced as engineering. Faculty of Engineering. So you should be careful with these kind of words. And this word also is not pretty. It is pretty. It's a pretty radical design. That is not pretty. Okay, it's a pretty radical design. Okay, moving on to the next read aloud. This is something about swans, and let me read it aloud first. Before European explorers had reached Australia, it was believed that all swans were white. Dutch mariner Anthony Kan was the first to be amazed at the sight of Australia's black swans on the Shark Bay in 1636. Explorer William D. Vlaminck captured two of these creatures on Australia's Swan River and returned with them to Europe to prove their existence. See, there is a proper noun. Anthony Kan. This is pronounced as Anthony Kan. And this is not creatures. This is not creatures, that is creatures. Captured two of these creatures on Australia's Swan River. So you have to pronounce it as creatures. And coming to this, this is not Europe. As we have pronounced this as European, this is not Europe. It is Europe. Okay, this is Europe. And coming to the third read aloud, that is Japanese tea ceremony. That is not pronounced as ceremony, it is ceremony. Japanese tea ceremony. Let me do this. The Japanese tea ceremony is a tour influenced by Buddhism in which green tea is prepared and served to small groups of guests in a peaceful setting. In Japan, tea ceremony is a ritual-like formalism in which green tea you prepare and serve to multiple guests in a tea-full setting. The ceremony can take as long as 4 hours, and there are many traditional gestures that both the server and the guest must perform. See, most of us feel this as gestures. That is not gestures, that is gestures. Okay, that is pronounced as ja. Although here gest is pronounced as ga, this is gestures. Okay, and this word is Buddhism. That is Buddhism. Yes. Coming to the fourth read aloud, which is repeated recently, and you can see it on the screen as avalanche. Yes, that is avalanche. Avalanche is rapidly descending large mass of snow, ice, soil, rock, or mixtures of these materials. sliding or falling in response to the force of gravity. Avalanches, which are natural forms of erosion and often seasonal, are usually classified by their content, such as a debris or snow avalanche. When we are pronouncing this as avalanche, this is avalanches. And here we can see this word as debris. That is not debris or something else. That is pronounced as debris. This is the collection of read aloud, which are repeated recently. And coming to the next question. Next question is repeat sentence. See, most of the students feel it as a difficult task. Moreover, it is very important as it is an integrated task. It contributes to speaking and listening module as well. It will be very easy if you know few strategies of repeat sentence. Before going to this recently repeated material, let's discuss one of the strategies. Okay. Firstly, concentrate on the content part. That is, try to remember the words of the prompt with its meaning. Speak those words fluently and clearly. Be super confident while doing your repeat sentence. Don't try to copy the accent of the speaker, but follow the tone of the prompt. This is very important. Okay. And in your exam, you may get 13 to 15 repeat sentences, in which 4 to 5 might be lengthier, and some repeat sentences will be short. And try to present 100%. Try to give your 100% performance in those short sentences. If you miss a couple of words or half of the sentence in the lengthier repeat sentences also, that might not be an issue. Okay, so for scoring 79 plus, this repeat sentences is very important. And the repeat sentences which are repeating these days are: the US ranks 22nd in foreign aid, given it as a percentage of GDP. That is a short sentence, you can easily produce it. Residence hall is closed prior to the academic building, closing time at the end of the semester. Next, when demand for the course rose, university authorities took on additional academic staff. Meeting with mentors can be scheduled for students who require additional support. Yes, when some of the sentences like no more than 4 people can be in the lab at once. If these type of sentences are very fast, see, we get some short sentences, but the audio will be very fast. In that case, what you have to do? Just if you go through the repeated material, you'll have an idea what were the words in that particular repeat sentence. So you can repeat it. That is why repeated material, going through the repeated material is very important. Okay. Then coming to the lengthier sentences, like let me take a lengthy sentence. Okay, yes, 27th. This is somewhat a lengthy sentence. The pyramids have been standing over thousands of years and draws tourists from all over the world. First, while the speaker is repeating the sentence itself, just concentrate on the gist of the sentence. You have to understand the meaning while he is presenting only. Yes. The pyramids have been standing for over thousands of years. Means pyramids have been standing for over thousands of years and draws tourists from all over the world. I have broken this particular sentence into three chunks, like the pyramids have been standing for over thousands of years and draws. Yes. Do I have such time, that much time to break that sentence? No, you don't have. But while practicing, just practice in this way, then it will be very easy for you to produce your repeat sentence. Yes. And the thing is, see, some people, what they do 50 repeat sentence and they get bored and go to the next question. That is not at all good. Practice at least 100 repeat sentence in one go. That will give you a perfection. Okay. Don't take only short sentences. Take lengthier sentences as well. First, start with short sentences, then go on moving your limit of the length of the words to more. Yes. So whenever you come across this kind of lengthier sentences also, don't worry. Whatever you have listened, whatever words you grasp, just produce them. Okay, and let's do a few. The United Kingdom is a constitutional monarchy and parliamentary democracy. So what is United Kingdom? Both constitutional monarchy and parliamentary democracy. Rules about breaks and lunch time vary from one company to next. So rules about breaks and lunch time vary from one company to next. If you understand the sentence in this way, it will be very easy for you to produce it. The office opens on Monday and Thursday, directly follow the freshman seminar. Yes, every photograph knows how important sunlight is to get good pictures. These are few repeated sentences which you get these days. And before going to the describe image, as we all know, third question in the speaking module is describe image. Coming to describe image, most of the students feel it as the toughest item in the speaking module. However, after this webinar and a little bit of practice, you people feel it as an easy question to be scored. Yes, believe me. Before going to the repeated describe image, let me discuss our strategy. Okay, there are many strategies in describe image, but I'm going to explain you one among them. As this question is scored only for speaking, I'm telling you this is not an integrated task. It is scored only for speaking. Hence, your fluency and pronunciation are examined here. Only your fluency and pronunciation. No grammar is scored from the speaking module. Hence, don't concentrate on framing sentences. Framing sentences doesn't fetch you points here. Yes? Then, coming to the describe image. The first image which you can see on the screen is something like a foot pyramid diagram. Okay, when you see on the screen a describe image, what we have to do in this preparation time of 25 seconds, just go through the words, whatever words are written on the screen, go through them and don't try to frame sentences. Don't concentrate on framing sentences. Just give your presentation. Okay, let me describe it first. The given diagram is an image. This pyramidal diagram gives information about different diets. When we look at the diagram, it is clear that there are five stages in which fats, oil, and sweets are at the pinnacle, whereas the pillar of this pyramid is with 8 servings of water. Last but one stage is filled with rice, pasta, cereal, and bread with 6 servings. The other two stages are subdivided into 4 stages, which consist of dairy products, meat and nuts in one stage, and fruits and vegetables in the other, with 2 to 3 servings each. In conclusion, it seems that drinking more water by avoiding fats and sweets is the formula for good diet. See here, we have spoken for some time. Let's take, we have spoken for 30 seconds. You have to click next immediately after speaking. Okay, after your recording is completed, just click next immediately. This is something a professional way of doing a describe image. If you don't know the way of speaking like this, what you have to do? Just pick up the template provided by PT Tutorials and fill it up using the words which you can see on the screen. Okay, it will be a very easy format for you because fluency and pronunciation are only important here. I'm repeating again and again. Coming to the next diagram. Let's move on to the next diagram. Yes. It is something related to population pyramid. Okay, now let's start with the sample response. The given image, a bar graph, this population pyramid illustrates the age and sex structure between two different countries, India and France. The percent of the population is distributed along the horizontal axis, with France shown on the left side and Indians on the right. This graph displays male and female populations, with the youngest groups at the bottom and the oldest at the top. Coming to the difference between India and France, the people in France live for about 85 years, whereas Indians' life expectancy is only greater than 70 years for both male and female. No need to give much about this diagram. No need to explain the things like, see, this is a, I've already told you that this is a professional way of speaking. But if you want to score perfect 90 in speaking, your fluency is very important. I'm telling you, your fluency score is mostly calculated from this particular question. Yes. So don't worry about grammar or content. Yes. And let's move on to the next question. Yes, this question is also repeated these days. So this is a typical diagram which you can see on the screen now. And this is a some process and the inquiry process shown in Australia in the year 2015. Okay, if I learn this diagram process prior, that is, if I know this diagram, if I have seen this diagram before, then it will be okay for me in the exam. But if I see this particular diagram suddenly on my exam day on the screen, what happens? My mind will be blocked and I don't understand what to explain, what to describe about this particular image. In that case, what you have to do, you have to, okay, let me first give my sample response, then give you some tips how to explain this particular image. Okay. Yes, the given image represents the inquiry process of the Australian government to identify and examine a written request called the terms of reference. In the first stage, research and consultation will be conducted. This process is followed by issuing paper and making a formal call for submission. By looking at the image, it is clear that the third and fifth stages include a review of subs associated with further consultation. And the fourth stage contains discussion papers, which are typically much more detailed documents than issue papers and will be called for further submissions. In conclusion, each inquiry culminates a final report which must be delivered for the government's response. Yes, I have included all the points which I can see on the screen. Okay, now let me give you one thing. Let me tell you one thing. If you have no idea about this image and how to present it, read whatever you see on the screen. That gives you points for speaking. Yes. For example, the given diagram is a flow chart, or the given diagram is a process. This process shows the inquiry process, terms of reference in Australia in the year 2015. There are six different steps here. Initial research, issues paper, review of subs, discussion paper, review of subs, and final report. We can also see the starting and ending point of the arrow that includes terms of reference represented by TOR and government response represented by, they are shown in green color, whereas other steps, other stages are shown in blue color, with initial research, consultation, issuing paper and calls for submissions, review of subs with further consultation, discussion paper and call for submissions, review of subs with further consultation. Then the final report is produced. What I have done here, just I have spoken whatever I have seen on the screen, whatever I see on the screen, just I produced those words. This also is accepted by Pearson. Okay, this is also accepted by Pearson. Now let's go to the important question which is repeating these days, that is desalination. Sorry. The diagram which you can see on the screen now is desalination. Here we can see different items like ocean, fresh water, salt minerals, energy and everything. Okay, let me describe it first. Okay, the given diagram is an image. This image represents the process of desalination. There is a huge amount of water available in the oceans, but this cannot be used because of dissolved salts. Although the energy consumption associated with the desalination process has reduced dramatically, it is still an important factor. Moreover, this is a process that takes away mineral components from ocean water. That is, this process removes dissolved salts and minerals from water. Ocean water is collected and recycled to fresh water by consuming energy. It is clear from the diagram that the energy is taken from sun. Yes. If you haven't seen this image before and you saw it only on your exam day, there is no chance to speak about it at least 20 to 25 seconds. What is the solution then? Just go through the diagram a couple of times in your preparation time. That means you have a 25 seconds of preparation time, and go through the diagram a couple of times and just prepare what you have to do, what you have to talk about, what are the words written on the screen, like desalination, salts, minerals, ocean water, energy, fresh water, like that. What's happening there? Salts and minerals are collected at the bottom of the container. Yes, something like that. Go on speaking something about it. That fetches you marks for speaking module. Okay. If you're not able to present this type of response, just go on talking about diagram. Like, go on talking about the colors, shapes, anything, whatever you see on the screen will do. Okay. I'm telling you, you can even repeat the sentences. Okay. Repeat the sentences. Like, the diagram is about desalination, and if you have completed it only in 10 seconds, then again, you can repeat the sentence. The last item in the speaking module is answer short questions. Yes, that is an answer short question. That is not a describe image. Okay, that is an answer short question. This answer short question will contribute to speaking, listening, and vocabulary. If you give a correct answer, you will be scored for all the three sections. That is listening, speaking, and vocabulary. Whereas if your answer is incorrect, you will be scored only for speaking. Because something, you have produced something, you have talked something. Okay. Yes. In order to score 79 plus in listening and writing also, practice more answer short questions. Why am I talking about writing in this item? It is because you have score for vocabulary from this answer short questions. Okay. And PT Tutorials app has most of the repeated answer short questions. Just go through them a couple of times and you can. Okay, you will do. And I want to tell you one thing. Don't stay mum for 3 seconds. That is, if you don't speak for 3 seconds, the mic will be off automatically. Give some answer instead of staying silent. Just produce some answer. Okay. Let us do this question. What is this process called? This process, it is extinguished. And this diagram also is repeating this answer short question. What is the name of the fish? Puffer. Okay. Yes. And some questions are giving with images and some questions are coming just like that. Let's look at this question. Use of periodic table is in which subject? See, from our childhood days, we hear this word periodic table, where is it? It will be in chemistry. It is in chemistry. And the next question, what happens to ice when it is heated? It melts. See, the question can also be asked in a different way, like, what is the solid form of water? That will be, your answer will be ice. What is the solid form of water? Ice. What happens to ice when it is heated? Melt. So whenever you're preparing a question for answer short questions, just be prepared in a such a way that if Pearson twists the question and give it to you, yes, you'll be in the position to answer. Okay. Yes. Coming to the question number 15. Which hospital department would you go for an X-ray? Radiology or cardiology? The answer is radiology. If you're not sure with the answer, you don't know the answer, but you have two answers there. What you have to do, instead of staying mum, I'm telling you, instead of staying mum, give an answer. You can give both the answers because you're not sure. If you are sure, go with one answer only. Okay. But if you give the both, if you give both the answer which you have given first will be taken by the computer. In worst case, you can do this. You can give both the answers because giving a wrong answer or staying mum, it depends on your luck if you give two answers and if the first one is correct. Agree? And if you are in the worst case, you can use this strategy. And okay, this is all about speaking module. And if you have any questions, I'll just answer you after this presentation. And these are the questions: how many hours in a day? 24. Sorry. Which ocean is located on the west of the US Pacific Ocean? And yes, you can go through all the questions and you can find all these questions in your RPT tutorials app. Moving on to the reading module. Okay. Moving on to the reading module. We have three order paragraphs on the screen. Here, first try to find the general statement. How to do a reorder paragraph first? Let us talk about that. First, try to find the general statement. That is, an opening statement should be identified first. Then try to make pairs. Making pairs is very important here rather than making a sequence. Concentrate on making pairs. That will fetch you points. Okay. Let's discuss one of the strategies of reorder paragraphs. Actually, the reading module has no strategies. There are no tips, there are no tricks for this particular reading module. But I can say that a few grammatical rules might help us in solving these reorder paragraphs. Okay, let me explain that first. Let's look at this particular reorder paragraph, that is benefit of language. Yes. Coming to benefit of language, let us look at this. It was the development of a standard musical notation in the 11th century that allowed music to be documented in a physical form. It means what? We don't know. What is it? It is a pronoun. This will not be the first statement. Over the years, many human endeavors have had the benefit of language. This might be the first statement. Yes. But it is difficult to describe music in words and even more difficult to specify a tune. Now music could be communicated efficiently and succeeding generations would know something about the music of their ancestors. In particular, a written language can convey a lot of information about past events, places, people and things. Okay, now after going through the passage, after going through the jumbled sentences, what I came to know that the first opening statement is, over the years, many human endeavors have had the benefit of language. That is something or fits in the opening sentence. Yes. Now let me explain your strategy. See, first go through the, okay, we have find it an opening sentence. What to do next? Just look at the last part, that is object of this particular statement. Had the benefit of the language. Okay. Search if there is any subject related to language. It was developed and standard musical, music, language, no. It was described music, no. Now music, no. In particular, a written language, yes. So B and E will be the pair. Here, B and E will be the pair. Yes, let's now B and E are the pair. Now let's start reading this particular statement. In particular, a written language can convey a lot of information about past events, places, people, and things. That is, this language is giving some information about something. So let's look that if this subject is carried forwarded somewhere else in the subject. It was the development of standard musical notation. Actually, music has not come yet. But it is difficult to describe music in words. This might be because they're talking about a positive thing of a language. But it is difficult to describe music in words. It is easy to describe language, it is easy to present language, but it is difficult to describe music in words and even more difficult to specify a tune. Yes, so now the pair of B, E is followed with C. B, E and C. Now let's go to the next, let's find out the next statement. Is it A or D? Okay, it was the developed of standard musical notation. Then comes now music could be communicated efficiently. Okay, feeling like these two might be. So what we have to do in this case? What we have to do? Pair these two first. That is, let's go through these two statements. It was the development of a standard music notation in 11th century that allowed music to be documented in a physical form. Now music could be communicated efficiently and succeeding generations. Okay, so as music is documented in a physical form, it is easy to be communicated. So it could be communicated efficiently. So A and D will be the pair. What I have done here is, after E, I was not able to get a pair. So I went on to A and D to make a pair and made A, D as a pair. Now, what is the correct answer? B, E, C, A and D. Is it clear? The answer is D, E, C, B and D. Why? Because I have paired these two statements here. Clear? As music is in physical form, it is easy to be communicated. Okay. Coming to the next question. Let's take something. Okay. Yes, earthquake. Let's talk about earthquake. Let me explain you one grammatical rule from our collection. Whenever you see a definite article the, here is a definite article the. See, I cannot say that all the times, but sometimes the fire, that is this the fire, will not be a general statement. That is an opening statement, because this fire might have been talked somewhere else. First, it will be talked somewhere else, then comes the fire. So, but Pearson is very clever, and to confuse us, what Pearson does, just he selects paragraph from the middle of the article. Okay, he selects from the middle of the article and gives us as reorder paragraph. In that case, there is no chance. That might be the first statement. In that case, what we have to do is just go through few webinars by pttutorials.com. We have prepared a webinar on reorder paragraphs also. Just go through that. Yes, before, yes. Now coming to the repeated material, that is earthquake, reorder paragraphs. What might be the first statement? But when calculating destruction, the earthquake took second place to the great fire that followed. At 5:12 a.m. on April 18, yes, this might be the first statement. The fire, as I've told you, will not be the result of the rupturing. No. The main trembler, no. So these two might be the first statements. Let's go through them. But when calculating discussion, the earthquake took second place. Okay, so there is some calculation. At 5:12 a.m. on April 18, 1906, the people of San Francisco were awakened by an earthquake that would devastate the city. Yes, this is the first statement. Then comes what? Let's look at the object. An earthquake that would devastate the city. Earthquake, well, calculation, no. Fire, no. The result, no. The main trembler. What is trembler? Trembler is a synonym for an earthquake. So the word earthquake has been explained. Yes. So the main trembler, having 7.7 to 7.9 magnitude, lasted about 1 minute. So B is followed with E. And comes. Okay, so yes, the main trembler, having 7.7 to 7.9 magnitude, lasted about 1 minute and was the result. Sorry, this is a mistake here. and was the result of rupturing the northernmost 296 miles of the 800-mile San Andreas Fault. Yes, so something here, they are calculating something. But when calculating this destruction, the earthquake took second place to the great fire that followed. So, B, D, this is D, these both come under D, B, D, A, and next. Yes. The fire lasting 4 days most likely started with broken glass lines. And give me a minute. Okay, actually I've missed one statement here. That statement will be ending with the fire. Let me explain you at the end about that. Okay, now let's move on to the greener technologies. Yes, can you people do this question? I'll give you 1 minute to solve this. Greener technologies. Yes. Yes, meanwhile, I'll bring that earthquake. Yes, answered by greener technologies. Yes, Hardik Patel, you have given your answer as DBAC. Any more answers? Greener technologies, I need an answer for greener technologies. Okay, let me explain you that. Yes, so First, let us start with the opening statement. Not only there are some good career opportunities, but there is a lot of money going on to the research side too. No, the energy sector means this energy, the energy sector somewhere has been explained before. With the pressures of climate change and energy gap, so engineers are much needed to develop greener technologies. Yes, this is something, an opening sentence. Engineers are much needed to develop greener technologies. And what might be this, the next statement, that is, what might be the pair for D? Not only there are some good career opportunities, but there is a lot of money and the energy sector. Yes, this greener technologies is paired with the energy sector has a fantastic skills shortage at all levels, both now and looming over it for next 10 years, he says. So D, B will be the pair. Next, what will come? Not only there are some good career opportunities, but there's a lot of money going into the research side too. Okay, next is, with the pressures of climate change and energy gap, in the last few years, funding from the research councils, this too might be there. So now what we have to do is just compare, understand the meaning, understand the objects. But there's a lot of money going into the research side. First, going money, then comes, in the last few years, funding from the research councils. After going money, then comes funding. So what will be the answer? D, B, A, and C. I'm telling you again, D, B, A, and C is the answer. Now we have missed this earthquake. Let us do this now. Okay. The fire lasting 4 days most likely started with broken gas lines, and in some cases was held along with the people hoping to collect insurance for this property. They were covered for fire, but not an earthquake damage, something. Okay, this will, as I've told you, this will not be the first statement. These all will not be the first statement. The first statement is E, that is, at 5:12 a.m. on April 18, 1906, the people of San Francisco were awakened by an earthquake that would devastate the city. Okay, it's clear. What will be the pair then? It is something ended by an earthquake. So the main trembler. What is trembler? What is trembler? Trembler means an earthquake. So it should be something related to that. So making pairs is very important. E, B is a pair. The result of rupturing the northernmost 296 miles of the 800 mile San Andreas fault. Yes, we are calculating some destruction. But when calculating destruction, the earthquake took second place to the great fire that followed. Great fire. Here the object is related to some fire. This fire is carried forward again to the fire here. Okay. So what would be the answer? E, B, C, D, and A. Here, if you have any questions, yes, I'll answer your questions after this webinar. Let us go with the actual presentation now. Next, reading blanks. This is very important. If we have right strategies and appropriate methods, then it is very, very easy to solve this fill in the blanks. How to score maximum in this reading blanks? See, reading comes only through reading. If you go on reading something, you will improve your reading skills. Read a lot of articles. Okay, go to sciencedaily.com, select your favorite topic from there, and select an article from those particular topics. From that particular topic which you have selected, select an article and go on reading those articles. When you select your favorite topic and read that, what happens? You read it with understanding. You understand them properly. If you come across a new word in that particular article, if you have came across a new word, then just Google it. Google for its meaning, and if there are any collocations regarding that, just Google. And you keep a separate book and note down some points. Okay, that will help you. Okay, that will help you a lot. Yes, coming to this reading blanks. Yes, screen was frozen. Yes, coming to the reading blanks. First one is, spending too much time in the concrete jungle is bad for city health and could have potentially catastrophic. Okay. Spending too much time in the concrete jungle is bad for city dwellers, today, yesterday, fortunes, expense, dwellers. So go through all the options. But I feel dwellers is there. Why? Because dwellers, city dwellers is a pair. Like, spending too much time in the concrete jungle is bad for city today, city yesterday, city fortunes, no, city expense, city conspiracies, city opportunities, dwellings. It may be city dwellings or city dwellers, but they are talking about city dwellers. City dwellers, health, and could have potentially catastrophic. Today, yesterday, fortunes, expense, no, conspiracies, opportunities, dwellings, consequences. What? Any answer? Catastrophic, conspiracies, or consequences. See, catastrophic consequences is a collocation. If you can Google, just Google for catastrophic consequences, you get it as a collocation. So going through few collocations is very important. And it will be very easy for you to solve this particular fill in the blanks. For the environment, conservation. Okay, for the environment, conservation biologist Richard Fuller will argue during a seminar at the University of Canberra. Today, yesterday, fortunes, expense, not all this, but it might be between today and yesterday. Will argue during a seminar at the University of Canberra. Will argue. When you see the word will, that will be obviously today. Canberra today. Dr. Fuller, lecturer in biodiversity and conservation at the University of Queensland and CSIRO, will explore the fact that although there is evidence that the well-being of humans increases with fortunes to our surrounding, with expense to, no. What is that actually? What is the meaning? There's evidence that the well-being of humans increases with the conspiracies, opportunities, dwellings, exposure. What does fit here actually? Exposure. Humans increase with the exposure to our surrounding biodiversity. The dash for people, the yesterday, fortunes, expense, the conspiracies or opportunities. These two might fit there. But what is the meaning of a conspiracy? Conspiracy means something, we can say the secret plan. So, opportunities. The opportunities for people to experience nature are declining rapidly in the modern world. This is one of the important reading blanks, which we can see these days. And shall I give you this? Will you do? Can you do the second one? Yes. Thank you. We now need to think of retirement as a phased process where mature age workers gradually reduce their hours, simultaneously reduce their hours, barriers, immediately delay, stop, babble, babble. What comes there? See, while we are performing, yes, while we are performing our describe image also, we can see that there's a gradual decrease, gradual increase, something like that. So gradually, that is the word gradually here. Gradually reduce their hours and where they have considerable flexibility in how they combine their work and non-work time. Okay, we also need to recognize the border change that is occurring in how people work, learn and live. Increasingly, we are moving away from a linear relationship between education, training, work and retirement as people move in and out of jobs, careers, caregiving, study and leisure. Employers of choice remove the simultaneously between, barriers between, immediately, delay between, stop between, bubble between. What might fit there? You can answer in the questions box. You can send your answers like Satyendra is doing. Santil, yes, give your answer. Employers of choice remove the barriers. Yes, it is remove the barriers between. Remove the barriers between the different segments of people's lives by creating flexible conditions of work and a range of leave entitlements. They have an individualized approach to workforce planning and development so that the needs of employers and employees can be met at side by side, that is simultaneously. That might be simultaneously. Okay, that might be simultaneous. Next. Let's go to the last question of this webinar. That is last question. It is also a reading fill in the blank. The Dag Hammarskjöld Library at United Nations headquarters in New York is a library designated to facilitate the work of the United Nations and focuses mainly on the needs of UN Secretariat and diplomatic missions. Anyone with a valid United Nations headquarters grounds, popularity, public security interest, pass, transit, passage. See, United Nations headquarters grounds pass. Yes, grounds pass. Then comes including specialized agencies, accredited media and NGOs. Staff is able to visit the library. Okay, due to, if we don't know the meaning of the whole passage also, till here we did not read anything. Anyone with a valid United Nations headquarters grounds pass, because grounds pass is a collocation. Grounds pass comes together. Okay, due to dash constraints in place at the United Nations headquarters complex, the library is not open to the general dash. Due to some security reasons, if we haven't read the previous part of the passage also, we can answer this. Due to security constraints in place at the United Nations headquarters complex, the library is not open to the general public. Yes, that is public. Okay, and if you have any questions, then just ask me. Let me answer your questions. Mohit Agarwal, thank you. are so many answers, so many correct answers also. Yes. Okay. Mohit Agarwal says, I want to practice for mock test. Yes, we have PT tutorials. We have so many mock tests. We are giving you the voucher as well. If you buy a voucher from us, it will be, we'll be providing you 50 mock tests. And you can do the mock test from there. Yes, any more questions? You can ask the questions in the questions box. Yes, Sohil is asking, could you please share this document? No, Sohil, actually you can find all the questions in PT Tutorials app. Just download it and start practicing. RV, please assist on above question. What is the question? Can you please post it again, the question? Yes, very useful webinar. Thank you so much. Is the question document available for share? No, you can find all the repeated questions and all these questions in the PT Tutorials app. Just go through them. Can you repeat the strategy for repeat sentence? Yes, I'll do. And Srikant, which sections contribute to vocabulary? Yes. Answer short questions from speaking module, from writing. You'll be scored for vocabulary from summarized written text and essay writing. Okay. From listening module, you'll be scored from summarized spoken text. And from reading, writing, fill in the blanks. Sushil, thank you for webinar. Welcome. Hem Singh, what if we don't know pronunciation of a particular word in real read aloud? Do we need to skip that word or try to pronounce? You have to pronounce, try to pronounce, because see, if you go through the, see, why are we providing repeated materials? Why are we providing these? Because you will go through some words which you are not aware of. Yes. And you can go through the PT Tutorials app and you can find many repeated read alouds there. If you are not aware of a word, if you're not aware of that pronouncing of that particular word, just type that word in Google and you can find an audio symbol there. Listen to the audio symbol, okay? And you can practice like that. You have to, because if you skip a word, what happens? It is considered as an error and you don't get the contribution for the reading module. Yes. RV, how to study for collocations? There are so many in English. Is there any list that can be used for PTE relevant to exam? Okay, if you can Google for PTE academic collocations list by Pearson, you can find them. Just go through them a couple of times, that's all. And I don't have any problem in reading, listening. Sam, okay. So your problem is with speaking. Don't worry about speaking. Just improve your fluency and pronunciation. You can easily score 90. You haven't explained about written lecture, Magesh. Yes, actually there is, as we have only a limited time, we could not do that. But we'll try to do it in another webinar. Yes, Dinesh, is there any rule guide for recording in PTE app? Yes, we can record. Mohit, okay, this is the question box. Anwar, Srikant, where to find this material in PTE Tutorials app? Just install PTE Tutorials app in your mobile. You can find the bulk of questions. Sarita, which sections have negative marking? Yes. Multiple choice, multiple answer in reading and listening module and highlight incorrect words. These are the three questions you are having a negative marking. Okay, Sam, your question is, I don't have any problem reading and listening. However, I stuck at writing and grammar. Okay, so that might be your problems with spellings also. Okay, grammar, just go through some of the grammatical rules that will help you. Okay, next, how to practice for reading. Yes, I've told you, Padma, just go through the website sciencedaily.com, pick up some interesting articles from there and read them. Collect some collocations from there and write down the meanings of the words which you haven't known. Tani, hi, can I see the first one of reorder paragraphs? Yes, I'll show you that. Do we have repeated questions on the PTE tutorial website? Yes, you do have. Yes, practice reading tapes, no tapes. Only reading, reading, reading. That's all. Are we? How to study for collocations? Yes, I've answered your question. Sarita, which questions have negative marking? Yes, I've answered yours as well. Madhu Kumar, if we evaluate tests, you'll be showing areas of improvement. Yes, you can mail for help desk. They'll surely respond you, and they'll show you the areas of improvement. What are your weak areas, where to improve, and what to do as well. Yes, how to study. Padma, Mohit Agarwal, can you evaluate? Yes, we have an evaluation also option. You have to pay for that, and for that, just you can download PD Tutorials app and so start from there. John, thank you, John. Udai, thank you. Padma, short answers, general questions. Yes, they will be general questions. Most of them, 99% of answer short questions get repeated. Okay, just go through them. We have so many bulk of answer short questions. Sagar Patel, what will be the markage for fill in the blanks in reading? For correct answer, you get 1 point. Incorrect, no point. And for reading, writing, fill in the blanks, that is drop down, you'll be scored for reading and writing. Okay? Yes. I'm having exam on 6th February, John. Okay, all the best. And just follow the last minute tips also, webinar done by PT Tutorials. Sohil, thank you so much. And okay, Reza, what can I obtain the template? Where can I obtain the template for describe image? Yes, just down install Telegram, join PT Tutorials group. We have a group called PT Tutorials. It's for free. You can ask any questions. You can post your recordings, and from there you can get the template for describe image. And thank you, Mohit Agarwal. Writing, listening. Okay, you'll do webinar for other modules also, writing and listening. Yes, we are preparing for that as well. Yes, Sushma Chowdhury, this is Sushma. Okay, Neha, if we have pronounced a word wrongly, can we try speaking again or move further? No. If you speak again, it is considered as a fumbling. When you do that, what happens? Your oral fluency score will go down. Gone is gone. Just move on. Okay. What about writing section? Yes, we'll do one more on that. Yes, voucher price. You can find it on the website, please. Tanit Singh. Yes. Any trick to identify collocation words out of the option given in the exam? Yes, if you're perfect at reading, and if you start reading some articles, it will be very easy for you. Next, how to pronounce nouns like read aloud? Anthony can. Yes, for this itself, I'm telling you to go through the repeated material. If you go through the repeated material, see, it is not very easy for you to pronounce Anthony can in your exam. We may pronounce it as CAEN when it's written like that. Antony San, something like that. So when you go through the repeated material, just if you don't know how to pronounce that particular word, type it in the Google, listen to this its pronunciation and follow. Clear? Roshini, in writing, where we need to write single sentence, should we use synonyms? Okay, you're asking me in answer short, summarize written text, right? No, don't paraphrase the passage. The keywords from the passage should be taken exactly. You should not paraphrase them. Don't use the synonyms as well. Padma, welcome Padma. Yes, next. Sarita, if we are not sure of the essay questions and don't know how much, don't know much about the topic, how do we answer to score a 90? Yes, you can watch a webinar on essay writing. There will be a webinar on essay writing. You can go through that. See, as human is not evaluating, Sarita, here, it's a computer. It's not a manual correction. So ideas are not that important. Whatever you're writing, write something about the content. Don't repeat the words. Okay? Write something about the content and follow the structure. Follow the structures and don't use any template. And Anil, so in reading and writing, fill in the blanks, one correct? Yes, there is no negative marking. There is no negative marking in reading, writing, fill in the blanks. But if you produce the correct answer, you get 1 point. If the answer is incorrect, you don't get any points. Okay, that's all. Any more questions? Is it good to use a template for describe image to score 90? Nabin, yes, you can use, because I don't suggest you to use a template in writing, listening modules, but you can use in the speaking module. For describe image, 100% you can use. When, yes, Sushma was asking, will template for SST and RTL and SWT work? No, in order to score 79 plus, you should not use templates for summarized spoken text, written lecture, and summarized written text. Why? Because if you use template, what happens? There are other words, and what we have to write, what we are producing the keywords, will be only few. Try to produce maximum keywords from the lectures and passage as well. Don't use templates. Templates doesn't work at all. It doesn't fetch you 79 plus. Yes, Nagadipti, can I speak long repeated sentence and get 80 plus overall? No, why to skip that? Collect some words. At least you will hear half of the sentence. Okay, half of the sentence, if you are perfect, produce that half sentence. You will get points. But don't skip it. You will not at all score 79 plus if you skip that. Yes, Sam, this is a free session. Padma, in listening sentence, if I get total meaning of the sentence, can I write in my own words? I didn't get your question. Is it in summarized spoken text or repeat sentence? If it is in summarized spoken text, no, you should not use your own words. But pick up the exact words from the lecture. That's all. Yes, any more questions? Okay, Javed was asking, if you answer right in answer short questions, then do you get marks for listening, speaking, and it happens to repeat questions when you don't know the answer? See, speaking is evaluated only through your fluency and pronunciation. So if you give some answer, then it will be accepted. But you don't score for the particular task. Like, for example, if listening, if you are giving the correct answer, then only you get points for listening. I think I've explained you this. Yes, Padmain, repeat the sentence. Yes, you can. Any more questions? Hope I've answered all the questions. Any more questions? If you have any questions, just ask me. Yes, Padma, welcome. And if you have any queries also, you can download PT Tutorials app, Telegram. After downloading Telegram, search for PT Tutorials. Just join there. If you have any queries, you can text there. Our experts are ready to answer your questions. Your questions are over. Okay, Madhu Kumar is asking, how many points do we get if you repeat half of the sentence? If you repeat more than half of the sentence, if you miss a single word or a couple of words, or you have missed half of the sentence also, you get 2 points for content. If you are fluent, if you have spoken that with clarity, then you get points. 5 points for pronunciation, 5 points for fluency, but only 1 point will be deducted for your half sentence. Okay, so you can get 12 points if you have produced it confidently. That's why I was telling you to be super confident while producing your repeat sentence. Neha Gupta. Yes, Neha Gupta, you can. Yes, this recording will be updated on the YouTube. You can find the recording there. Okay, it will be uploaded in the YouTube. Then you can go through that. I have many problems with write from dictation. Please give me repeated material for that. Yes, you can go to PT Tutorials app. We have so many write from dictations, more than 500, I suppose. And we will be updating that every week as well. So you can find over there, Krishna. In reading section, will reading fill in the blanks and reading writing fill in the blanks have the same weightage? No. As reading fill in the blanks scored only for reading, reading writing is scored for both the modules. That is reading and writing. Obviously, reading writing blanks have the more weightage. Yeah? Yes. If you're done with your questions, we'll end the webinar. If you have any queries, just download Telegram, join our PT Tutorials group, and you can post your queries there. We will be answering them. Okay, I think the question section is over. Okay, over. Yes. Thank you so much. And I hope the lecture was clear. I'm ending the webinar. And let's meet on next Saturday webinar and learn some new tips and strategies regarding other modules. Okay. Thank you so much.